Welcome back to How to TB on our new series on Kubernetes. We're going to continue again our topic about Kubernetes on how to deploy our deployment for our pod. Okay, and yeah, so we're going to be interactive here as we going to continue this video. Without further ado, let's go. And we are here right now with my killercoda, one are going to use for our simulator. Again, so we're not going to use a minikube here. If you're going to use a minikube for this for the sample, so you can do so. You can also check that on my video, or the last video that I have on how to create how to install step by step on minikube. Okay, and we have here our deployment that we have, and we're going to deploy some images of Nets engine, and we're going to create a replicas. Okay, one of the role of deployment is you can create some replicas here. Okay, so you have an auto healing here. If you have not working container here or pod here, he will automatically create a working pod here. Okay, so we're going to have a sample example here. Okay, and going back here, I'm going to create again my sample alias here for our kubectl command. In order for us, we will not type it all the time, the Kubernetes, and that's again working. And if you're going to get pods, so we don't have our resources for now because we refresh our killercoda, so we're going from the sketch again. And to recap again, in order for us to get all the information of our pods, you can type this one. Okay. And if you're going to another information that we can get to our pod, you can add a parameter of A. Okay, so there you go. We have a lot of informations here, valuable informations for our pod and for our deployment replicas. Okay, so yeah, we're going to do right now our first deployment. I'll name it deployment this time around. Okay, and going back here, I'll copy this one for sample. You can play around any manifest YAML file that you want. If you're going to do this one, this is a example of the Kubernetes that we can create a deployment. So this is what we're going to do here. And let me say, if you're going to create one or two replicas here. Okay. So meaning I will create a one pod here. Okay. Control O and then X. Okay. I'll clear screen, Control L. And then I'm going to apply what we created. Deployment YAML. Okay. So you created our first deployment. If you're going to check here, get pods. I type it wrong. There you go. You're starting creating it. And if you're going to create it, if you're going to view in another display, and there you have it. Okay, this is our first container. Again, we're going to back here. It is running. Okay, our status is running. Okay. So that's the simple a command that we can create a deployment. So if you're going to curl again, and then what's the let's again the get O and Y. This is the IP address. Okay. And then if you're going to curl this, our Nginx is already running. Pins on it. And there you go. So it's successfully created. Okay. So right now, if you're going to rename edit the deployment YAML manifest file that we have, and then we change it to numbers of replicas, meaning three pods or two pods, or it's up to you how many pods that you want when you're creating the pods here. So you can create it. Let's say it's the file name, okay? So go to nano again, and then play around with this YAML. And if you're going to set our replicas to, okay, or three copies or replicas. Okay. So we're going to remove first what we have before. We're going to remove this. So the command is k delete pod and this one. There you go. There you go. Then paste on it. And let's delete. Okay. We're going to create again. Okay. Apply. Deployment. The name of the manifest file. And YAML. And here. We're going to he will create our deployment, our three manifest file or that three replicas. If you're going to view it in a live, creations of our, this is the command. Okay, so he created three replicas right now. Okay, so here's the twist, guys. So the advantage if you're going to use a deployment, because if you're going to deploy three replicas, and then if in the scenario in our productions, if something happened with our pod here, maybe it's corrupt or having specifications problem, okay, the memory is getting high, and then it didn't work well of the container, the pods, and it destroyed, or it will remove. Okay, so what we're going to do right now, since we are watching right now our pod, here's the thing right now. We're going to access our new tab, and then what we're going to do right now, we can type again the pods. So server say that one of our replicas is not functioning, and it did destroy one of our pod here. So we're going to have a scenario here. Going to remove one of, for example, delete pod, and then what's the name of the pod that we're going to remove here? For example, this one we're going to remove. So this scenario is malfunctioning, and then it did delete, okay, in the productions, because you know the container is a term there, ephemeral. So it will not last long if there's a problem, it will delete. So for example, if we're going to delete this one, so we can check here what's the problem right now. Okay, so they terminating right now one of our pod here. What he going to do right now is replacing one pod has destroyed. Okay, so you see he replaced the one pod that we deleted. Okay, if that scenario is that the pod is not working well, and it did delete, okay, it damaged, so it will create right away, because in our deployment we declare a three replica. So the deployment at the RS, what we call that, I forgot the term of RS here, replica set. Okay, one of the replica set to be set here is three, so he will not allow it that the replica set that we declare is not complete. It's not complete. So it's supposed to be there's to be a pod should be running here, three pod. Okay, because our pod is already corrupt, and if delete, he will replace another one. So that's the advantage of the deployment. So here we deploy a three replica, and then the advantage of deployment, it will create what is the given replicas that we declare in our deployment YAML. Okay, so yeah, that's it. So that's our first deployment for our pod, and I hope that you are learning again for this simple tutorial that we have on how to deploy our first deployment by creating a 3 pods and a scenario if there's a pod is not working well and it will delete, and it did delete, it did damage, and then it replaced. So that's the beauty of the deployment. It will replace your 3 set of replicas. Okay, so that's only it, and I hope that you're learning again for this topic on Kubernetes, and I'll see you around in the next video.